a moment and share with you a little bit about stress. Now, whenever I talk about the word stress, whenever I teach on stress in the Bible, one of the things that I always just think is as soon as I tell people, hey, let's talk about stress, what happens? We all get stressed out, don't we? That's just how it works. But let me just ask you a question. Are you feeling stressed these days? Of course you are. Everyone is feeling stressed. You're home with your kids, maybe a lot more than you planned. You're home with your spouse, maybe a lot more than you planned. Work is getting really challenging or difficult, and maybe you're dealing with some really important questions, right? Questions like, am I going to get sick? Questions like, am I going to lose my job? Questions like, will I have enough money? And was my money gonna run out? And then we're all asking the question, do I have enough toilet paper, right? We're all wondering that. If I see toilet paper, do I have to go buy some? How do you answer these questions? Now, look, some of these are really serious questions, but the point is, we all feel stress. We all feel stress over these situations. And you know, we're not the first people who have felt stress over our circumstances. Humans have always felt stress. In Jesus's day, 2,000 years ago, you might think, oh, that was a simpler time back then, but people were stressed. They were stressed over, where am I gonna live? Am I gonna have food? Am I gonna have enough money? Am I gonna be able to pay my taxes? These were questions that people had 2,000 years ago in the time of Jesus, and they're questions that people have today. And so what's interesting is, what did Jesus say to people who were worried? Well, we don't have to wonder. He tells us in Matthew chapter 6. And so if you're worried, if you're stressed right now, especially if you're stressed about the future, what might happen, what could happen, what may not work out like you want, I want to encourage you to check out the words of Jesus in chapter 6. Now, in Matthew chapter 6, Jesus is talking about it's in his Sermon on the Mount. And there's a lot of good stuff we have on pursuegod.org on the teaching of Jesus and Jesus from the Sermon on the Mount. And actually, today, I'm taking this from a conversation that we have on the website on Pursue God about future stress, stressed over what might happen in the future. And it's in that context that Jesus is speaking to people, and he tells them in Matthew 6, he says, are you stressed out? Are you worried? I'm paraphrasing here. Are you worried about money? You know, are you worried about what you're going to eat and what you're going to wear? And then he famously says, you know, consider the birds. They don't worry, they don't fret, they just, you know, trust God to provide for them. Look at the lilies in the fields. You know, they are wonderfully and beautifully clothed by God. They don't worry about what they're going to wear. And so, Jesus then says to us, and I want to read this for you in Matthew chapter 6, verses 31 and th through 33. Here's what Jesus says. He said, so don't worry about these things, saying, what will we eat? What will we drink? What will we wear? These things dominate the thoughts of unbelievers. But your heavenly Father already knows all your needs. Seek the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and he will give you everything you need. Now, this passage is a really famous passage of Jesus, but I want you to read it for yourself, and then I want you to go from here and have this conversation with someone else in your life. But let me just say a few things about it. What Jesus is saying here is, he's like, look, we all have questions like, what are we gonna eat? What are we gonna drink? You know, how are we gonna get through the next few weeks? How are we gonna get through the next month or so? Jesus says, here's the thing. These concerns, these worries dominate the thoughts of unbelievers. Now, what does he mean there? What he means is that if you don't believe in God, if you don't trust in the God of the Bible, if you don't believe that God's going to provide for you, then yeah, you might freak out and think, how are we going to get through the coronavirus? How are we going to get through this time? You might panic, you might not be able to sleep. You might think, okay, God's not going to give me everything I need. But if you believe in God, if you believe in your Heavenly Father, then you should trust Him. You should know that God is ready and going to provide for everything that you need. And so let me just share with you three different ways to deal with stress. Deal with stress about the future. If you're stressed about what's going to come up, here's three ways to handle it. The first, and these all come from Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. All of these come through that. The first is this: seek God first, right? That's what it says there. It says, seek the kingdom of God above all else. Or is it famously said in the King James, seek ye first the kingdom of God. And we used to sing a song like that when I was a kid. But seek God number one. Now, what does that mean? We all have in this unique time, we all have the opportunity to reset the priorities of our lives, meaning all of our lives have slowed down. Like I was just thinking yesterday, so much of my afternoons and evenings were taking kids to sporting events, and now that's all just gone. That's all just done, right? Don't worry, we still have lots of homework to do, maybe even more homework than we've ever had before, but we don't have as much sports. And my schedule, although really busy for with church stuff in a lot of ways, has really changed. And it's an opportunity for me and for you and for my family and your friends and your small group and other people you mentor. It's an opportunity for all of us to kind of hit the reset button and say, what's priority number one in our lives? Who is number one in our lives? And the Bible says, let God be the priority. That's what it means. In an uncertain world, in an uncertain time, in a confusing, frustrating, scary time, who should we make number one? It's God Himself. Seek God first. So use this time to put God number one in your life. Don't try to control your future, but put it in the hands of God. Get to know God, listen to God more. Make reading His word a priority. Don't give up on that. Instead, I'd say double down on that. Spend more time talking to God, listening to Him, praying, getting to know Him. Read the Bible, read good Christian literature, do devotionals, all that kind of stuff. Seek God first. The second thing, and again, it's right here in Jesus's words, live righteously. Live righteously now. We tend to build our lives naturally as humans. We tend to build our lives searching after the things we want in life, right? I want more money. I want a better house. I want to get married. I want my family to be like this. I want to get really fit. Whatever it is, we make our plans for our lives. And what the Bible says is here's what our plan should be. It should be to live righteously. Now, what does that mean? What does it mean to live righteously? What it means is to learn to live to honor God with your life. Instead of being consumed with the pursuit of money or security, learn to be wise, learn to trust God. One of the ways that I think about living righteously is, the Bible says that if you're a Christian, if you're a follower of Jesus, that God wants you to live more and more like Jesus once you become a Christian. And so one of the things we say at Alpine is, that means you want to live to honor God with your life. And so that's what we want to do. We want to say, my most important thing is not to just have all the questions answered of where am I going to get all my money from? Or, what am I going to do if this terrible thing happens? Certainly be wise, certainly plan for the future. Definitely do that. The Bible has so much to say about that. But God also says, hey, priority number one is to live righteously. And you know what? If I freak out on my wife because I'm scared about the future, or if I kind of teach my kids that we should just be worried and afraid, it shows them that I don't really trust God, that I don't really have faith in God. And so to live righteously says, I'm going to honor God. And that means whenever I'm concerned, whenever I'm worried, I'm going to go to God. I'm going to bring my concerns to God, and then I'm going to trust Him. And so seek God first. Live righteously, live to honor God. Say, how can I honor God? How can I bless people in my conversations? And then lastly, receive what God gives you. Look at what it says there at the end of the passage. He, God, will give you everything you need. God's going to give you everything you need. Now, God may not give you everything you want. He might not give you just every last thing. He might not make your savings account as big as you hope to go through a rough time, but He's going to provide for your needs. And He's going to do that in lots of creative ways. So learn to be content. Yesterday I went on a hike. I went to Antelope Island to do some social distancing. I was socially distanced with thousands of other people, but we were maintaining space, so it was good. And I saw the birds flying, and I was thinking about this passage, and I just thought, these birds are not freaking out about everything going on in the world because they just have sort of this trust that the universe is okay because it's in the hands of a creator. And so you and I, even though times are scary, times are tough, we need to trust God. We need to trust that He's going to provide and give us everything that we need. So those are just a few thoughts from this passage. I want to encourage you that this is not the end of, I hope this isn't the end of your thoughts on this passage. I want you to go and take this conversation that we've started and continue it. Continue it with, if you're married, your spouse, continue it with your mentor, continue it with your family. You can find some discussion questions, I believe, attached to this video that we're going to have up. And keep the conversation going as you pursue God and as you learn to trust Jesus in the midst of your stress of the future.